There's a section in the at River City, I call it Defense Industry Row, where we have an Exxon GrafTech frame built up into a bike. We have a Teledyne Titan built up as a bike, and we have a Mossberg. Basically, all those companies were involved in the defense industry, and they were branching off into bikes for some reason. The Exxon GrafTech was probably the most, well, that and the Teledyne, those are both pretty successfully raced back in the 70s. John Howard raced on an Exxon. I think I saw him win the national championship in Louisville, Kentucky on a GrafTech. And then there was, and Teledyne Titan also had a couple of, you know, very, very good pros racing on their frames. But this was carbon fiber at its infancy. I mean, they really did not know how to make carbon fiber bikes. And they weren't that much lighter than the steel frames that were out there because everything was overbuilt. And they didn't really understand about the weaving or, you know, really much of the carbon fiber technology at all, like we have a much better understanding of now. I got that one from Craig Calfee. Actually, I was visiting him maybe 10 years ago or so, and I saw it sitting in the back by his office, and I just kind of picked it up and said, okay, Craig, I'm gonna take this. I got it and built it all up with more or less period components from that era. I didn't want to, I've got, you know, almost every bike that I have there is built up with Campagnolo stuff on it. And this one, I have it built up with like the Shimano stuff and like Sugino and like Hi-E wheels. I mean, some, you know, different kinds of, you know, instead of just the traditional European stuff. You know, I do kind of like that it was a commercially produced frame. You could order one. Anyone could order one and buy one. I remember looking at them in the catalog way back when, and they were like probably two or three times as expensive as a steel frame, but it was like the first exotic frame that could be had by any racer or anybody who just wanted that type of bike. The Mossberg is a prototype. I'm quite sure that never made it into production, but they made a run of, I think, like 20 of frames of those. I had never seen one of those before. I was just paging through eBay one time and it came up. For some reason, I placed a bid and won it, but it was a highly unique frame for that time. One of the things I like about that is it has the absolute first generation of Shimano Durace, which was highly unpopular back then. It was really perceived as being, you know, far below Campagnolo in terms of quality, in terms of the, you know, just the longevity of the components and the way that the brakes worked and everything else. Boy, there's a lot of weird things on that bike. It has two sets of seat stays for some reason. One, you know, it's got the standard one that attaches up by the seat lug, and then it has this auxiliary set of seat stays that attach to the top tube, maybe 6 inches away from the seat lug. And then the brake bridge is not really part of the seat stays the way that most other frames are, but it was just kind of clamped on. Well, you know, I guess the opposite of the Exxon, I do kind of like the idea that was never really on the market. it was designed as a prototype by an arms manufacturer, you know, someone who was making shotguns and sidearms and everything else that I guess just saw the bike boom as a natural, maybe an easy way to expand their business. And you know, whenever big companies do that, you know, I think most of them rapidly learn that it's not as easy as they may think that it will be.